हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू गियर मी अप ट्रैवल एंड फोटोग्राफी चैनल। एंड टुडे आई विल डिस्कस हाउ टू शूट अमेजिंग टाइम लैप्स वीडियोस राइट फ्रॉम योर स्मार्टफोन। इन दिस वीडियो वील टॉक अबाउट यूजिंग अ स्मार्टफोन कैमरा टू शूट टाइम लैप्स वीडियोस। वी विल ऑल्सो डिस्कस द अदर इम्पॉर्टेंट गियर यू नीड टू गेट सम आउटस्टैंडिंग रिजल्ट्स। Although most of the smartphones nowadays have built-in time-lapse mode in their native app, I suggest using a dedicated app for time-lapse shooting. Framelapse is one of the most popular free apps, which gives great flexibility in setting up the time-lapse. Let's see the user interface and settings in Framelapse app. After opening the app, starting from the top left corner, there is a play symbol that gives access to video gallery. You can access all your recorded time-lapse videos from here. Just below that is the video resolution setting for time-lapse recording. High resolution gives better quality but consumes large memory space and also may heat up your smartphone. So setting it up to 1080p gives good balance between quality and space consumption. Next is the camera settings. There are different settings option in this. The first option is to set the self timer. You can keep it off as you will be using a tripod anyway. Next option is the focus mode. Set it to infinity for landscape shooting. Or if the object is closer to camera, like a flower, set it to macro. Next is white balance. Avoid setting it to auto and set it as per the lighting conditions. For shooting clouds, set it to cloudy daylight. And for shooting sunset time lapse, set it to twilight. Next option is filter settings. I suggest to keep it none to get the natural colors in your time lapse. The last camera setting is exposure compensation. Again, set it up as per the lighting conditions. Once you have dialed in the camera settings, do remember to lock the exposure and white balance. This is very important because if they are kept on auto, there will be flickering and changes in color that will mess up your time lapse. After camera setting, next setting is frame interval. This is the interval between each captured frame. It is the most important value for your time lapse recording. You can set it from 0.1 seconds to 24 hours. To make sure you have dialed in the correct frame interval, you need to understand the basic rule. If the target object is moving fast, the frame interval should be set to low. And if the target object is moving slow, the frame interval should be set to high. For example, if you are shooting people or street traffic, set the shorter time interval like 0.5 seconds to 1 second. On the other hand, if you are shooting slow moving objects like clouds, set higher time interval like 5 seconds to 10 seconds. After frame interval, next you can set the length of the time lapse you wish to record. I'm setting it to 7 seconds as per my requirement. If you find frame interval setting a bit confusing, using speed value is more intuitive. This is basically how fast you want the video to play back. It's as simple as that. Changing speed value will automatically change the frame interval setting. Lastly, on the right bottom, there are options to add camera grid, lock notification, shutter sound, etc. I suggest you turn on ignore notification to avoid any interruptions while recording time lapse. In the options menu, there is a setting for selecting video frame rate. I shoot my videos at 24 frames per second, so I will set this one to 24 frames per second. So that was the camera settings part. Now let's talk about the photography gear that you need to shoot your time lapse. The first and obvious gear is a tripod. You need a stable support for shooting your time lapse videos. Depending on what you want to shoot, you can use anything from tabletop tripod to a full-fledged professional tripod. You'll also need a smartphone grip like this to mount your phone on the tripod. The second gear I would suggest is a Bluetooth remote shutter. This will allow you to start and stop the recording without touching the smartphone to avoid any shakes in the video. Another interesting gear is the rotating camera mount. This will add a linear movement and change in the perspective in your time lapse. There are a lot of other settings and gear that I can discuss over here, but I want to keep this as simple as possible. And I'm sure with all that we have discussed in this video, you can shoot some exceptional time-lapse videos from your smartphone. So that's it guys, I hope this video was useful. If you like this video, please hit that like button and subscribe to Gear Me Up channel for more photography reviews in future. Thanks for watching.